From the Galen Center at the University of Southern California, we love Ella, a tribute to the First Lady of Song. And now our host, Natalie Cole.
When I was a little girl, about 6 years old, this was the first jazz song I ever learned. A little cool nursery rhyme goes something like this. A tisket, a tasket, a brown and yellow basket. I wrote a letter to my mommy. On the way I dropped it, I dropped it, I dropped it. Yes, on the way I dropped it. A little girl, it picked it up and put it in her pocket. She was trucking on down the avenue without a single thing to do. She went peck, peck it all around. Then she spied it on the ground. She took it, she took it, my little yellow basket. And if she doesn't bring it back, I think that I will die.
To the University of Southern California's beautiful, brand new Galen Center. I know it's gonna be a very, very special concert. We are all here to say, we love you, Ella. Now, back in the day, when my father was playing the Central Avenue clubs that were just a few blocks from where we are right now in downtown LA, everybody who mattered had a nickname. There was the Duke, Ellington, the Count, Basie, and long before Elvis Presley, my dad was known as King Cole. And Ella had more than one nickname too. Some referred to her as Miss Fitz. The musicians who played with her called her Sis. Actually, when I was a little girl, I called her Auntie Ella. But a long time ago, somebody came up with the perfect description for the woman we're here to honor tonight. And ever since then, Ella Fitzgerald has been known simply and elegantly as the First Lady of Song. As a singer, Ella really could do it all. So to pay proper tribute to her immense gifts, we needed to bring together a lot of very talented people. Our first guest is a woman whose roots are in country, but her voice is so big, she can sing anything. Please welcome Wynonna!
Most of you know me as Wynonna, but tonight, I'd prefer it if you would refer to me as Miss Behavin.
That's right.
I recorded one of Ella's songs. She's one of the very first sheroes in my life.
No one to talk with,
all by myself. No one to walk with, but I'm happy on the shelf. Ain't misbehaving, saving my love for.
Fabulous. That's my girl. Our next performer is a four-time Grammy nominee who for the past dozen years has also been spreading the gospel of jazz as the host of a radio show that is heard around the world. I've been a guest on his show a few times, and he's played on my records, and those are just two of the reasons why we're all very pleased he could be here with us tonight. Here is my friend, saxophonist Mr. Dave Cogg.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, help me welcome to the stage, Mr. Reuben Studdard.
Do nothing till you hear from me. Pay no attention to what's said. Why won't you tear the seams of anyone's dreams? Oh, is over my head. Do nothing till you hear from me. At least consider our romance. If you should take the words of others you've heard, I haven't a chance. Oh, true, I've been seen with somebody new, but that doesn't mean that I'm untrue. When we're apart, some kiss may cloud my memory, and others' words may hold a thrill. Oh, but please do nothing till you hear from me, and you never will. Reveal how I feel about you. Some kiss may cloud my memory, and others' arms may hold a thrill. But please do nothing till you hear from me, and you never will. And you never will. Never will.
It's a genuine thrill for me to say, please welcome my co-host, my friend, my mentor, a true giant in music, Q, Mr. Quincy Jones.
Thank you so much. I remember when I first started out as a trumpet player after World War II, if you wanted to play bebop, there was one group of musicians that every hot young cat wanted to be with, and that was the Dizzy Gillespie Band. That was it then. Bella once told me that it was Dizzy and his all-star hot musicians who had started the scat, that she just wanted to talk to them in their own language, the way they talk to each other. No words, just the most inventive sounds in the world. Ella took what the musicians did and popularized it, and in the process, she became one of the great, great jazz artists of all time.
Sweet and lovely lady, be good. Oh, lady, be good to me. Oh, lady, oh, lady, be good to me. Say I'm all alone in this big city of L.A. Won't somebody please have pity, 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 pity on me?
Boo-dee-loo, bee-dee-loo, boo-dee-loo-loo, bee-doo-bee. Bee-bee-bee-bee-bee-bee-bee-bee. I don't know where I'm going from here.
You could choose only one singer for your all-star jazz band. There's no question that it was the lady who could swing, who could scat, who could bop till you drop. Now, to join in on a tribute to Lady Be Good, a recording that was really an artistic breakthrough for Ella, here are the extraordinary composer, my old buddy from a long time ago, and pianist George Dookie Stick Duke. A drummer and occasional house guest, best known for his work with Count Basie and Frank Sinatra, Greg Field. A trumpet player who Dizzy always thought of as his musical son, the great John Faddis. Meatloaf. And the bebop legend who was back there with Ella back in 1947 when she recorded the song we're about to hear. He is my beloved big brother from the bottom of my heart, who stood me up and put me on his shoulders when I was in New York. I was 21 years old and broker than the Ten Commandments. I'm so happy to say here's my brother from another mother, Mr. James Moody.
Thank you very much, man. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, 60 years ago, I was a member of Dizzy Gillespie's orchestra. And thank you. Now, that was 60 years ago. Now, the 10th of January in New York City, my wife Linda and I, we were fortunate enough to be there for the unveiling of the Ella Fitzgerald stamp. Thank you. Which means that the post office got hip. So much spiritual love to Ella, and happy birthday, Ella. Hee hee.
Now, to honor Ella's jazz vocal tradition, all the rules she broke and the new ones she made, here's one of my very favorite singers, who just happens to be my sweet and beautiful goddaughter since she was 4, and a group of young guys who I've been in love with since I first heard and worked with him 20 years ago. Please give up all the love you got to Patty Austin and Take 6. They can do it. Yes, Lord. What can you say? You get better and better and better. For everybody here tonight, we all learn from what came before us and then try and make our own individual contribution to the art. In other words, if you know where you're coming from, it's easy to get where you're going. One of the most exciting parts of tonight is when we get to pass the torch to honor Ella's legacy. At the same time, we introduce a new generation of artists. In the miniseries Roots, we wrote a song based on a Nigerian folk song. It was called Many Rains Ago, and it says, Ishe Oluwa Koliba Jowo, which means what God has created, nobody can take away. Now I'd like you to meet an artist whose name is a Nigerian word, too. That means to come here and bring forth. She's an accomplished songwriter and producer and a serious, serious powerhouse of a singer. Here's my Kidara Lerisi.
My mama done told me when I was in pigtails. My mama done told me, a man's gonna sweet talk and give you the big eyes. But when that sweet talk is done, a man is a two-face, a worrisome thing. Leave you to sing the blues in the night. Now the rains are falling, hear that train a calling. Ooh-wee. My mama done told me, hear that lonesome whistle blow.
Our next artist grew up singing gospel in her father's church, and she was saying backstage that when she could, she would turn on the radio and sneak a listen to a little jazz or pop. Then when she was 19 and in college, she started sitting in at clubs, singing standards, and it was there that she really connected with the music. If you haven't heard her before, you're in for a real treat now. Please welcome Liz Wright.
A little over 30 years ago, a good friend of mine wrote a song about jazz. Can't believe it's 30 years. And in the lyric he sang, with a voice like Ella's ringing out, there's no way the band can lose. Ladies and gentlemen, please give up the love for the one and only Stevie Wonder. Stevie Wonder!
Comfort, too close for comfort. Please.
I'm not big on statistics, but sometimes numbers do tell a story. During her lifetime, Ella won 13 Grammy Awards and sold over 40 million albums. Ella could sing anything, from swing to bebop to blues to standards, and she always did it with that mixture of innocence and sweetness, a voice that sounded effortless. Ella sang with true joy, and it was all the evidence you needed to know that God was a jazz singer. And a woman. To a snowy height. Each star its own aurora borealis. Suddenly you held me tight. And I could see the midnight sun. Found me, or was it a moonlit veil? The music of universe around me? Or was that a nightingale? And then your arms miraculously found me. Suddenly the sky turned pale, and I could see the midnight sun. Oh, was there such a night? It's a thrill I still don't quite feel. But after you were gone, there was still some stardust on my sleeve. Oh, the flame of it may dwindle to an ember, and the stars forget to shine. And we may see the meadows in December, icy white and crystalline. But oh, my darling, always I remember when your lips were close to mine, and we could see the midnight sun. Oh, the midnight sun.
Nobody who heard Ella sing ever thought about her color. When she sang, there was no black or white. There was just that special sound. Ella wasn't a black singer. She wasn't even a girl singer. She was just the singer. I worked with just about everybody in this business, and just about everybody thought Ella was the very best that ever did it. But as great as Ella was, you cannot be black in America and not face some serious challenges. Like back in 1955, this country was still very segregated. It was one of the reasons I was spending so much time playing and living in Europe. Anyway, a young songwriter by the name of Arthur Hamilton was asked to write a song for a movie called Pete Kelly's Blues. The movie set in the roaring 20s starred Peggy Lee. Ella was in it too, and the producer wanted Hamilton to write a song for Ella to sing. The producer loved the song that Arthur turned in, but asked him to make just one little change. You see, he told Arthur, the audience would never believe that a black woman in the 20s would use the word plebeian. So he rewrote the line 25 different ways, and finally he realized that plebeian was exactly the right word, and he was not going to change it. I love him for that. The song was dropped from the movie, though, and 20 years later, Ella recorded a version of it that has never seen the light of day until tonight. And with an arrangement he wrote for Ella, here is Mi Guapo Hermanito, my dear friend, three-time Grammy Award winner Jorge Calandrelli, conducting the USC Thornton Orchestra with the world premiere of Ella Fitzgerald's 1975 version of the classic Cry Me a River. Give it up, you guys.
Just to prove you do.
Is that beautiful or what? And here is something that's also very beautiful. When the members of Take Six were first starting out, their vocal dream was inspired by the all-time jazz greats like Ella. They took Ella's solo scat and put it into an harmonic blend that caught everybody's attention, including Ella's, because they ended up singing together on Quincy's classic Back on the Block album. I love these guys. I love their sound. So talented. Once again, here is Take Six.
Just in time, I found you just in time. Before you came, my time was running low. I was lost, the losing dice were tossed. My bridges all were crossed, nowhere to go. Well, now you're here, and now I know just where I've gone. And no more doubt of fear, I found my way. Just in time,
you found me just in time.
And changed my lonely life, that lovely day. Changed my lonely life, that lovely day. Oh, just in time, I found you just in time. Before you came, my time was running low. My bridges all were crossed, nowhere to go. Well, now you're here, and now I know
just where
I'm going. Doubt or fear, I found my way. Oh, just in time,
you
found me just in time.
Remember this, a kiss is still a kiss. The fundamental things apply as time goes by.
Shoo-be-doo-bee, shoo-be-doo-woo.
Mr. Alvin Chia, sing it away.
And now I know just what I'm going. No more doubt of here. I've found my way.
Just in time,
you found me just in time. And changed my lonely life, that lovely day.
Changed my life,
just in time.
Changed my life,
that lovely day.
Changed my life,
just in time.
Changed my life,
oh, changed my life.
Just in time,
changed my life,
that lovely day.
Changed my life,
just in time.
Change my life. I'm so glad that you found me. Change my lonely life. Change my life, that lovely day. Change my lonely life, that lovely day.
Take Six, ladies and gentlemen, Take Six.
I think everybody here remembers the first time they heard Ella's voice. For me, I think I was about 7 years old. My parents were always playing her records. You see, in the 1950s, as jazz's place in the world of popular music was being overtaken by rock and roll, Ella was encouraged by her manager and producer, Norman Granz, to move away from jazz, to go back in time to record a series of albums spotlighting the Great American Songbook. Ella embraced the idea, and she recorded what might be the definitive takes on dozens of songs by the likes of Cole Porter, Rodgers and Hart, Harold Arlen, and of course, George Gershwin. It was on these albums that Ella's effortless and instinctive style flowered in a way that really connected with an audience who wasn't quite ready to rock around the clock.
Ah, wonderful, marvelous, you should care for me. Adventurous dream. Love laughs at a king. Kings don't need a thing on the street of dreams. Dreams broken in two can be made.
Incredible. To sing one of those great George and Ira Gershwin standards on which Ella wrote the book, please welcome Miss Monica Mancini.
Back in 1984, when my mother, singer Ginny O'Connor Mancini, founded the Society of Singers, they named their Lifetime Achievement Award the Ella. Ella was the first recipient. So just so you understand what a big deal this was, Frank Sinatra was the second recipient. So between my mother, my father, who cherished his work with Ella, and my own ears, I grew up always knowing that Ella was simply the best. Old man sunshine, listen you. Never tell me dreams come true. Just try it. And I'll start a riot. Beatrice Fairfax, don't you dare ever tell me he will care. I'm certain it's the final curtain. I never wanna hear from any cheerful Pollyannas who tell you fate supplies a mate. It's all bananas. They're writing songs of love, but not for me. Lucky stars above, but not for me. With love to leave
I've found more clouds of gray than any Russian play could guarantee. I was a fool to fall and get that way. Hi-ho, lass, and also
choosing the songs for tonight was a challenge for all of us, but there are a handful of signature songs that have to be a part of a tribute to Ella, or otherwise everybody would be screaming. So the next song is pretty high up on that must-sing list. Once again, here is Liz Wright with Lullaby of Birdland.
Here when you sigh, never in my wordland could there be ways to reveal in a phrase how I feel. Have you ever heard two turtle doves, Bill and Coo, when they love? That's the kind of magic music we make with our lips when we kiss. Whisper low, lips when we kiss. And there's a way beyond we know. He really knows how to cry. That's how I cry on my pillow. If you should tell me farewell or goodbye, lullaby and birdland whisper low. Kiss me sweet, then we'll go flying high in birdland, high in the sky up above. And it's all 'cause we're in love. Lullaby in birdland, kiss me sweet.
I think I've known this next singer just about her whole life, and I'm so proud to share the stage with her tonight. A beautiful, beautiful human being and a beautiful lady, a beautiful talent, a real living legend, the gorgeous Miss Nancy Wilson. Give up the love, Nancy Wilson.
Thank you so much. I do thank you. When I was starting out, listening to everybody and trying to find my own voice, Miss Ella Fitzgerald was the gold standard. And here I am, 55 years later, and nothing has really changed. This is for you, my old friend.
Somebody I'm longing to see. I hope that he turns out to be someone who will watch over me. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Well, I don't think there's anything left for us to say except...
The concert was over at Carnegie Hall. The maestro took bow after bow.
Yes, he did. Mm-hmm.
He said, my dear friends, I have given my all. I'm sorry, but it's all over now. Then from the balcony, way up high, there suddenly came this mournful cry. Mr. Paganini, please play my rhapsody. And if you cannot play it, you sing it, and if you can't sing it, you simply have to.
Mr. Paganini, we breathlessly await your masterful baton. Yeah. And if you can't sling it,
well,
you simply have to. Rumble the dead, zuba dooby do you do, booba do you do, be ba da da wee.
Oh, yes, we heard your repertoire. And at the final bar, we greeted you with wild applause.
I remember.
But what a great your interpretation of I never get much for moonlit skies. I never wink back at fireflies.
Oh, would you, Paganini? Don't you be a meanie. What have you up your sleeve? Come on in, spring it.
Yeah, and if you cannot spring it,
Mr. Paganini, please play my rhapsody. And if you cannot play it, won't you sing it?
Since the boys are popping, ain't no need of stopping.
Well,
say it, tweet, tell you, boop, boop, say you, boop, boop, boop,
listen, Paganini, are we ready to see a wait? Are you a master of a time? Swing it, yeah.
Since the boys are popping and no need of stopping.
Heard your repertoire, and at that final bar,
we greeted you
with wild applause.
And what a great ovation.
Say it.